When setting up a simulation in COMSOL Multiphysics, there are many points in which you will need to select the geometry in your model, from assigning materials to defining boundary conditions, refining the mesh, or post-processing results. Selecting geometric entities can become difficult, especially when trying to reach an interior boundary or working with large and complex geometries. There are multiple ways you can select geometry in the software. In this video, we will show you how using the mouse in the graphics window, mouse scroll wheel, graphics window toolbar, selection list window, settings window toolbar, and preselections. So here we have the bus bar box tutorial model opened up, and this is a multiphysics model exhibiting joule heating and convective cooling. A voltage is applied to one of the bolts of the bus bar, which results in joule heating and causes the structure to heat up. An airstream, represented by the box, cools down the bus bar through convection. We will use this model to go through the different ways we can select geometric entities in the software. In this model, I've added the materials air, copper, and titanium, but I haven't applied them to any part of the geometry. For the material air, we want to apply it to the box surrounding the bus bar. So the first standard general method by which we can select geometry in the software is through the hover and click method. And this is especially useful if you are working with a simple geometry or are making selections of single entities. To use this method to select and apply the material air to the box, we first select the air node. Then we use the mouse and, in the graphics window, hover over the part of the geometry we want to include. You'll see the geometry turns red to indicate which part you are choosing. So now we can click, and our geometry changed to blue to indicate it is now selected. Next, we want to apply the material copper to the bus bar domain. So after selecting the copper node, in the graphics window, you'll see if I try to select the bus bar, I can't since the external geometric entities get in the way. In cases like this, we can use the mouse scroll wheel. The mouse scroll wheel is useful for selecting hard-to-reach entities or interior boundaries. So first, to deselect the box, I can just click on it again. Now I can hover with the mouse over the bus bar, and using the scroll wheel, I can toggle through the overlapping geometric entities and click the geometry that I want. If we were applying a setting like this to a boundary in the model, just as an example, we could do the same action. We would just hover over the part of the geometry we want, and you can see using the mouse scroll wheel, we can access all of the interior boundaries and select from those. You can also scroll through the layers of geometry using the up and down arrows on your keyboard or the two-finger drag on a touchpad. So I'll just return this to the original setting, and we can move on to our last material, titanium. We want to apply this material to all of the bolt domains in the bus bar. So we select the titanium node, and then we could go through and add each bolt individually using the scroll wheel button, but instead let's utilize the selection buttons in the graphics window to make this go quicker. The selection buttons in the graphics window toolbar are useful for when you want to create a selection of a large number of entities. You can do it all at once. You can use the select box to quickly select multiple entities that are contained fully inside the box we draw, so any entities that are intersecting the box will not be included. You can also use the deselect box to deselect any parts of the geometry that you want to remove. You can use the select all button to select all entities, or you can use the clear selection button to deselect all the geometry. So let's use the select box to quickly create a selection of all of the bolt domains. So now you'll see I'm going to make sure all of the bolt domains are fully contained in the box. And there you can see I've selected 6 domains very quickly in one instance. Another way we could have created this selection was through using the selection list window. To open the window, we would go to the Home tab in the ribbon, click the Windows button, and choose Selection List. The Selection List window is useful for selecting geometric entities that are not easily viewed and while working with complex geometries. It's also useful for when you know the geometric entity number you want to select, such as when you are following step-by-step instructions to build a model from the application library. So the bolt domains in this model are only somewhat visible in the geometry. So let's select the bolts again, this time using the selection list window. So first I'll clear the selection to start over. And we make sure, again, we are in the node we want our geometry selection to apply to, titanium. Then in the selection window, we can click and toggle through the geometric entity numbers, which will show the corresponding geometry highlighted in the graphics window. So we can kind of see where our bolt domains are. So now I can see I want domains 3 through 8. So I select all of those and click the plus sign button to add them to the selection. We can also use the minus sign button to remove any entities that we don't want to include. So when there is a possibility of overlapping geometric entities, it is recommended that you use the selection list window to ensure that the correct part of the geometry is selected. So next to our selection list window, we have the settings window toolbar, which is another tool we can use to select geometric entities. Returning back to the model builder window, previously we assigned air to the box domain, and now we want to simulate air flowing through the box and cooling down the bus bar through convection. So we want to reuse this selection for the heat transfer and fluids node. We can use the copy selection and paste selection functionality available in the settings window toolbar to copy and paste lists of selected entities from one node's settings to another. This method is useful because sometimes in a model, there are dozens of selections and it can really be tedious to create them manually for each node individually. So here we can click copy selection. Now we can select the heat transfer and fluids node. Click the paste selection button here, and simply right-click and paste in our selection. Now our geometry applicable for this node has been selected. In this instance, I copied and pasted only a single entity, but this method works really well with lists containing large numbers of geometric entities. The settings window toolbar is also useful for when you know the geometric entity number you want to select, such as when you are following step-by-step instructions to build a model from the application library. For example, if we refer to the PDF for this tutorial model, we can see under the laminar flow interface, we need to add a symmetry boundary condition and apply it to boundaries 134 and 48. So we can go ahead and add that under our physics tab, add the symmetry boundary condition, and we can click paste, and I can just go ahead and type in those boundaries. And they've all been added. Lastly, to select geometric entities for any physics settings in the model, we can use preselections. And this is useful for when you're adding physics nodes from the ribbon tabs. It's also useful for when you're adding a physics interface to selected geometric entities. We'll do this now by creating an inlet and outlet boundary condition for the inlet and outlet boundaries of the box. So in the settings window for any node under the geometry selection section, we can toggle off the active button, go in the graphics window and select the geometry we want to include. So this will be for our inlet boundary condition. We go and add that boundary condition. And you can see it has automatically been applied to our selected entities. We can do this again for the outlet boundary condition. So we go ahead and click it in the graphics window, create the boundary condition. And once again, that has been applied to our previously selected geometric entities. And now that I've added them, I can go ahead to the settings window for each node and make any changes needed. With that, we have showed you the many different ways in which you can select geometric entities in your model. In the graphics window, you can hover and click with your mouse to select geometry, use the scroll wheel on your mouse to select hard-to-reach geometric entities, use the graphics window toolbar buttons to select multiple entities quickly, utilize the selection list window for complex geometries, use the settings window toolbar to copy and paste selection lists of geometric entities, and finally use preselections when applying physics settings through the ribbon. To find out more about these and other relevant topics, please see the links provided in the description.